Hi everyone, I'm Latasha from websitesetup.org, and today I'm going to show you how to create a website using Wix Editor. And if you're new here, welcome. Websitesetup.org is a free online resource for learning web development, design, and WordPress. Our goal is to help beginners create their own websites, blogs, and online stores using the right tools and platforms. So to learn more about our review policies and processes, be sure to click the link in our description box or visit websitesetup.org. Wix is an easy-to-use, powerful, and quite affordable website builder. Today, we'll show you how to build a Wix website from scratch. Ready? Let's get started. First, go to wix.com and click on the Get Started button. Input your contact information and click on the main Sign Up button. After doing so, you'll be taken straight to what's called the Wix ADI, or Artificial Intelligence Designer. To begin, click on Let's Do It. In these initial steps, Wix will ask you a series of questions and then set your site up with specific optimizations in place based on your answers. Step 2 is to pick the type of website that you want to build. So with the initial questions out of the way, Wix will ask you if you trust the ADI enough to let it build a sample website for you, or if you want to build everything by hand. Going with the ADI is a much more efficient approach, especially since you can come back later on and customize every little detail of your site. So to move forward, just click on Start Now. Now, based on everything you've selected up until this point, Wix will suggest a set of features for your site. In our case, Wix suggests a module for online bookings, chat, a blog, and a handful of other things. Now, what you'll see on this screen can vary based on your answers, so go through this list and tick the features that seem like they make the most sense for you and your site. And in the next step, Wix will ask you about your business name. Then they'll ask you if you already have content on the web that you'd like to import to your new Wix website. Wix does allow imports from other websites and also from Google Places listings, but we'll leave this out in our case. In the third step, we'll choose a template or a design. Wix tries to make the design selection process as straightforward as possible. So instead of showing you a wall of hundreds of templates to choose from, it begins by asking about the style of design that you prefer. Based on your answers, Wix will present you with a filtered list of templates that are in line with your previous selections. As soon as you make a choice, you'll see that Wix puts together pretty accurate homepage alternatives to pick from. Based on your previous selections, these homepages will be pre-filled with relevant graphics and adhere to a given design style. Step 4 is to customize the site. You'll be thrown right into the Wix ADI editor after picking the homepage you like. There, you can customize every little detail about how the website appears and what elements it features. For instance, if you want to edit any of the text on the page, just click on a given piece of text. Clicking on any of the other blocks on the homepage will have the same effect, letting you into an editing interface where you can change the contents of that given block. Another helpful note, the Wix ADI editor does have an autosave feature, so you don't have to worry about losing all of your progress and hard work. But there's more to customizing your design than just changing text here and there. You can also realign the sections, switch the design styles of the sections, add new sections, set fonts and colors, and add images, slideshows, and other visual features. We've also added detailed instructions for each of these steps on our blog, which I'll be sure to link in the description box below. Step 5 is to tune up your site for mobile devices. These days, mobile phones are often people's primary devices for accessing the web. What this means is really simple. You absolutely must make sure that your website looks good on mobile. Luckily, getting your site mobile optimized with Wix is pretty easy. To begin, just click on the View Switcher button that's in the top bar. This will reload the page and show you how it's going to appear on mobile devices specifically. Any changes you make here won't affect the way your site looks on desktop. This is for mobile only. And Wix lets you customize a lot here regarding hiding different elements on the page, realigning entire sections, and so on. So take advantage of this and experiment with it for sure. When you're done, just switch to desktop view again and your changes will be saved automatically. Step 6, create other pages. Now that we have the home page ready, it's time to start working on some other pages. Most websites can benefit from having at least an about page and a contact page. So to get started, just click on the page home button that's in the top left corner, then click on add page. Wix already suggests some popular types of pages you might be interested in creating, and not by accident, the first suggestion on the list is for the about page. So to get your about page done, just scroll through the list of available page designs and pick the one that you like the best. The Wix ADI editor will reload the interface and let you work on your new about page. The ins and outs of how everything works are exactly the same as with the home page. By default, each new page you create is also going to be added to the main menu of your site automatically, and if you want to change the order in which the pages appear in the menu, just click on your site's header and then on the edit button next to menu. You'll then be able to drag and drop pages to reorder them. You can also add menu items by hand if you want to link to places outside of your website, like your social media profiles, for example. Step 7 is optional. You can add a blog if you want to. Blogging is one of the best ways to reach new audiences and turn those audiences into potential customers. From a technical point of view, starting a blog on Wix is really easy. You have all the tools required already built in. In the top menu, click on the page button and then add page. From the list, you'll select blog and then pick a blog layout that you like. You can edit this page just like any other page that you have on the site. And to write new blog posts, click on the main blog section and then on Manage Blog. Step 8 is also optional. You can also add an online store. This probably won't be a surprise for you at this point, but you can launch an online store with Wix pretty quickly. Plus, it will be a fully functional online store, not limiting you in any way. You can have an unlimited number of products. You get a custom storefront and cart design. You can sell physical and digital goods. You can track orders, set shipping rates, accept online payments, sell via Facebook and Instagram, and manage your sales on the go with the Wix app. Again, in the top menu, click on the page button and then on add page. And from the list, go ahead and select online store and choose a store layout that you like. To manage your store and add products, just click on the store section and then on manage products. In step 9, you'll want to get to know the main Wix dashboard. We've been dealing mostly with the Wix ADI and everything that can be achieved with it, which is a whole lot. However, there's also a whole separate Wix dashboard available. This is meant to give you a broader outlook on what's going on with your website and all of the different metrics associated with it. To access the dashboard, simply log out and then back into Wix. I'll explain what's on this page block by block. So A is the primary sidebar where you can quickly access the individual areas of your website. If you have a blog or an online store, you'll see sections to manage your products, your orders, blog posts, or bookings there. There are also links to other tools and apps, and at the bottom, there's a link to edit your site, which will land you in the same Wix ADI editor that we used before. B is the main control panel of your website. This is where you can choose from a selection of actions to perform on your site. And C is a getting started walkthrough. So follow those steps to make sure that your site is 100% ready to be seen by people. And further down the page, there are also blocks with more tips on how to use your site. The one additional area where you might want to have a deeper look is the settings menu, which is accessible from the main sidebar. This is where you can find all the key settings of your site, such as the name, general info, integrations with other tools, payment options, currency, and a lot more. For step 10, you can add functionality via Wix apps. If the features you get from Wix out the box aren't enough, we'd recommend taking a look at the Wix app market. There you'll find more than 200 different apps there to help you build and grow your website. To access the apps, click on apps in the main sidebar of the Wix dashboard. There are apps for all sorts of different things there, from marketing helpers to SEO, live chat, newsletters, social media integrations, pop-ups, A/B testing, cart abandonment tools, contact managers, and so much more. And lastly, you'll need to pick a pricing plan and launch your site. To publish your site, go back to the Wix ADI editor and then click on the main publish button. There, you'll have to choose whether you want to use the free Wix subdomain or connect a custom domain name. Now, there is an entirely free plan that Wix offers, but you're only allowed to use the free Wix subdomain and you can't connect a custom domain name. You also have some other limitations like Wix ads and a little bit less storage space. So if you're okay with these limitations, you can go ahead and choose that option. At that stage, your site is going to be online and ready to welcome visitors. Now, if on the other hand, those limitations are too much, you'll have to upgrade to one of the premium plans. We've outlined different pricing plans on our website too, so be sure to check out the link down below if you want to see a deeper analysis of each of those plans. Also important to keep in mind is you can always upgrade to a more expensive plan if you run into any significant limitations down the road. And that's it. As you can see, Wix is incredibly powerful and capable in the realm of DIY websites. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them down in the comments. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit us over at websitesetup.org for more info. Thanks for watching.